back, everyone. Today we need to talk about a few newer mods for Cities 2. Not too long ago, I put out a video on how to install mods, which I'll link below, along with some of the basic mods that had arrived. But now we have some more advanced mods arriving, and these are game changers for how we play Cities Skylines 2. So if you're new here, hit the subscribe button, leave a like, drop a comment down below. I'll put some links in the description so you can keep up with what's going on, and let's get to it. First mod we're going to discuss is huge, because this is something that I've been talking about since early access. And that mod is Anarchy. Why is this important? Well, we had Anarchy in CS1, and as you may remember, it gave us the ability to place anything pretty much anywhere. And now if you've played Cities 2, you know there are plenty of overlap pop-ups that restrict you from being able to maybe some of the things you're looking to do. Essentially, Anarchy is going to give you the ability to overlap. It's going to ignore some of the restrictions Cities 2 puts on you via the vanilla restrictions that are in place. And this affects more than just vegetation. For example, if I'm trying to place this parking lot down, you can see I get overlap indicators if I get too close to the road, but then it's offset if I just put it in where the zoning allows me to place the building. But let's say I really want this parking lot to fit this corner. I can then turn on Anarchy or hit Control A, and now I have no more overlap indicators and I can just drop the parking lot wherever I want. Now, something helpful that Cities 2 actually came with is the ability to move the building and turn off snapping. With that, I can place the building wherever I want. I can overlap the roads, or I can just try to get it right in this corner to close the gap that would have been there. And this is going to work with your unique buildings or anything that you plop down. This is going to be really helpful if you're just trying to fill awkward spaces or eliminate some of those awkward spaces you're left with because of how zoning operates or zone breaks that limit where you can place your buildings. Not only that, if you want to go a step further and utilize dev mode, you have more freedom here as well, where maybe the base game was telling you you couldn't overlap with certain props and things like that. With Anarchy mode actually activated, guess what? Those overlap indicators are gone, and you can actually detail surfaces that are within a building. So as you can see, I can pick random props or things out, and there's no overlap indicator blocking me from placing this on the parking lot. And before Anarchy, obviously you had limitations on how close you could get some of these props, but with Anarchy, no limitations. You can basically overlap them if you choose. Of course, as always with dev mode, you need to be very careful what you place down. I wouldn't place anything that spawns or does anything that may generate something. So I'd keep it limited to inanimate objects, benches, props, things like that. And keep in mind, this is not only for the parking lot. You can now place props on top of things like train stations, whatever building you're plopping down or zoning, you can add more detail if you choose. Anarchy is also going to give you more freedom with things like networks. So for example, if I want to place something closer to the train line, I can do that. If I want to overlap the train line with low voltage power lines, I can do that. This just gives you a bunch of freedom. And there's another big thing we should talk about. Obviously, when we first started playing CS2, I talked a lot about making keys with roads. Well, now it's even easier. Before, we were having to terraform and do certain things to make it possible. With Anarchy, you can do it on the fly. Even though the road is elevated, you still would often get these overlap notifications for being too close to water. So this just gives you more freedom and makes this whole process a little more user-friendly. And what's great is you don't have to build some massive wall to start your city at the river's edge. If this is something you're interested in doing, it can be low to the water and seem a little bit more realistic. Now, Anarchy also has some settings that are in the options of the game. And one of them is allowing you to place multiple unique buildings. This is something that existed in Cities 1 that I'm excited to see already integrated into Cities 2, because I know as we get more unique buildings or we start to see assets coming up on PDX mods when that's available, we're going to want to place them multiple times to help accommodate what we're trying to build. And now with Anarchy, you're able to, and you still get the benefits that you would had you placed the building for the first time. I think this will also be really helpful when trying to add unique industrial buildings to add jobs or just to add density in your industrial areas. Not to mention, I can now expand my specialized industry zone areas beyond the limitation that came with Cities 2. So that little circle when you place your initial building, you can go far beyond the radius that it provides, giving you more flexibility when you're building your specialized industry areas. The next mod we're going to discuss is something I also talked about in early access, and that was some sort of tree control mod, giving us more control over how we place trees or what type of trees we place. Now, obviously, you can pick in vanilla Cities 2 what tree you want to place, but it's always a youthful tree. I want more flexibility, and I've said that since the beginning, and I've caught some flack for wanting to be able just to have the option of placing a fully grown tree. I don't know why that triggers so many people, but thankfully now with Tree Controller, we can place that. We can do that. We can select what part of the tree's lifespan we want to place, and we can drop it down fully grown if we so choose. This is just a nice option to have. It is certainly not a requirement if you prefer trees to grow, but for me, I want some of that satisfaction of having an area complete and being able to see it in all its glory before moving on to something else. Now, if you want to keep the variety up, you can select multiple different ages that the tree can be placed, which you'll see gives you a little bit of a height variety there. Now, with the tree brush setting, you're also going to get a few predetermined groupings of trees, so you can make little forests. And with the Anarchy mod also applied on top of this, you're able to place trees much closer together. So if you want a dense forest and you keep running into that overlap issue with Vanilla Cities 2, guess what? You can make those dense forests as dense as you want. This is important because this mod continues to give us more control over our experience in Cities 2. I mean, you can even place dead trees. But let's go a step further. There's now a mod that gives you a little bit more control over placing trees and bushes in lines. We obviously had ducks in a row, which came up pretty early on, but it didn't give us a lot of a user interface. But now with line tool, guess what? We can control the spacing between these elements and also do a few other cool things in terms of adding random rotation and some spacing variation. So if you're someone that often used prop line tool back with Cities 1 to control how you did maybe little corners or little spots of detailing with bushes or trees, you now have that functionality built into Cities 2 with additional control and a user interface to make adjustments to how you control that setup. And of course, with the Anarchy mod on, you have a lot of freedom in terms of placement. And much like we're accustomed to, you can do everything from a straight line to a curved line to a circle. So this obviously speeds up the ability to create what you're looking for, to detail and to add some variety and personality to your city and Cities too. But let's take this a step further. What is another layer of customization for your city? Well, it comes in kind of two parts. First of all, you can get extra landscaping tools for CS2, something we had in CS1. And it's going to do the typical thing of being able to add ore or resources to your map. This can help you when you're trying to place farms in certain areas, or maybe you want to set up some sort of specialized industry in a specific location, but you don't have the resource naturally there on the map. But more importantly for me, from a detail perspective, you also get the ability to place services on the fly without actually having to open up the dev mode tools. This mod gives me a lot of hope for how Cities 2 will be modded in the future, which is a very user-friendly system. The icons are clear and you know what you're getting when you place it. And I think having these textures available on the fly across the board for anyone looking to just do some basic mods to your gameplay is huge, because it's, again, going to give your city a bunch more personality. Because as of yet, most cities are just this grass texture across the board. By using this mod, you can fill in some of those blank spaces between zones, or fill in some of those gaps, or create your own parks. I was always someone that was a big proponent of Theme Mixer, and part of that was because I really liked in CS1 how I could set up cities that looked like they were from different geographic locations. And a couple big aspects to that were things like textures, changing out how your grass looked, or altering the color temperature of your city through a LUT. But I say all that to say that I'm just excited to have textures incorporated, because again, it can at least add diversity in your city. And of course, if you're looking to maybe add some farmland somewhere without placing specialized industry, you can do that via surfaces and get the look that your farms should have. Now, like modding any game, you need to make sure you have dependencies. There is a dependency that a couple of these mods rely on, which is Unified Icons Library, which you can find on Thunderstore and GitHub. I'll link it down below in the description. But with that said, I think these are really great mods to have in your Cities 2 arsenal, and I would recommend checking them out if you get the opportunity or if you're interested in modding. If there's anything else you guys have tried or checked out, even maps, let me know down in the comments below, and I'll see you all next time.